I say? I'll read it to you. The first foundation is to know that there was the first existence before everything else existed. And he's the founder of everything. And he invented everything. And everything you see was invented and created by him. And all their existence is only thanks to him, nothing else. They don't have any existence of their own. They cannot benefit each other. Product one, benefit product two on his own. No. The only way they can benefit each other, help each other, complete each other, work together, is only thanks to him and thanks to his supervision and abilities. Without him, nothing can work. Without him, there's no creation, and without him, the creation cannot function. That's the first foundation. Second one, this master of universe is the leader of the whole world, an unlimited strength and ability whatsoever, doesn't have even a drop of weakness or something that is incomplete about him. And his strength never get lower ever, even by a tiny percent. There's no such thing fatigue by him. I need a rest. Let's take an hour rest. The world should go easy a little bit for an hour or two. I need to catch my breath. I work very hard today to supervise the world. There's no such thing. And there's no stoppage. And the wheel is always turning. And it can never turn without some energy who turn it. All the galaxies, all the stars, the rotations of each star, the movements, billions and trillions. Every star is 1,000 times bigger than Earth and turning and not colliding with each other. All their movements, all their temperature, all their energy is all coming from him. They don't have anything of their own. The sun temperature in the middle of the sun, the center of the sun is 15 million degrees Celsius. It's more than 20 million degrees that we have here. In 80 degrees, I'm fainting already. Imagine now, 100 degrees, I don't come out of the AC. I can't breathe. I can't move. 100 degrees. Imagine 15 million degrees. 20 million degrees. 20 million degrees. And for thousands of years, it never went down by 1 degree, ever. Always the same. Always the same. Where did the energy come from? What's the sun consume? It's a huge ball of fire. Fire needs to eat something. Wood, something, to catch up to something. Fire doesn't have food, fire will die after a minute. Where this fire, this ball of fire, constantly creating heat and light to the world? And there are so many others there. Who does that? It's only Hashem, it's Yesh Me'ayim. Constantly creating new energy, constantly, for thousands of years. So that's the second foundation. Nothing can happen here without his decision and without his will. Third, this God is only one, and it cannot be more than one. Right here, Christianity goes right to the waste. There cannot be any divine entity, only one. No two and not more than two. Right? Why? Because if you would have two gods, each one of them would be limited and subject to the other god's decision. If both of them are omnipotent, that's the right word. If both of them call Yachol, they have no limitation, can do anything, can create anything, imagine they fight now. They begin to go in a fight or a chess game. It will never end. It's because it's two perfect things. It will take forever. One wants this, one wants the other one. You know what would happen in the world? There will be a chaos. Once there is another perfect God, the first one is already not perfect. Then the second one is not perfect because there's someone else that can affect him. So anyone that is subject to any other entity's effect is already not perfect. And the Torah say clearly that that's the perfect God, and he knows the future, and he runs everything, and he controls everything. If there was another God, then we cannot rely on the one God that gave us the Torah. Maybe the other God doesn't like the Torah. Maybe the other God promotes same-sex marriage. Now they're going to go into a nuclear war. I want men and men to get married, and I hate it. It's abomination. Who's to say the last word? Boom, the whole world will go on fire. It's ridiculous. Don't get me wrong. We don't need all this philosophy. It's already written in verses in the book of God, and he's not a liar. But now we're analyzing it with our own philosophy and logic. Even if we didn't know that it's written in the Torah, we will still have to come to this conclusion on our own. So this God is one and not two and not more. Ela echad she'en ki yichudo. There's one that there's no one like him. Not from the people or anything that exists in this world, and not from anything out of the world. He's not one that is connected by few that connected to one. One piece like a car. You have engine, you have transmission, you have a carburetor, you have sensors, you have wheels. You connect everything, it becomes a perfect machine. You take one wheel out, the machine is worthless. You take one wire out, you can start the car, it's not worth a penny. If you take one sensor out, and there's nowhere in the world to get this sensor. This Bentley, from 300,000, went down to 3 cents. Maybe you can use it as a tent. Maybe you're gonna build a sukkah there. Cut the roof and put some branches. Why? You can use it. Wow, it's such a nice car. You cannot start it. And what good is that? So it means in order for the car to be perfect, it needs lots of pieces to be connected in the right places and in the right timing and to work together in a perfect harmony. That God is not like that. He's one. And there's no connections to him or upgrades or pieces who got together to create that perfect supervisor. If there were many gods, then we would not have any control in any events. Nothing would be certain. There would no point of giving Torah when there is another superpower who can overrule everything that it's written over there. God say, if you be mechalel Shabbat, you lose your eternity and you put to death. The other God would say, no, I disagree with this ruling. I want it to be like this. What are you going to do now? Follow the Torah or get the other God angry? It's not possible. He doesn't have anybody and he doesn't have an end. He will never die and he doesn't have a limit. And everything he does is with a very deep, smart purpose. This God, since he doesn't have any limitation and no end and no stoppage, he never stops in anything, everything constantly will always function, and everything will roll forever as long as he wants. Therefore, his physique and strength is different than the strength of every creation that was made by him. Like our strength is subject to many things. If you eat, you will have time, you will have energy to walk. If you fast a week, you're not going to be able to move. Meaning your entire energy depends on other things. Even that is limited. It's subject to many different things in the body to function and other things that you need in order for you to function and to be able to talk or to walk. But he doesn't depend on anything. His strength is perfect, will always be perfect, and nothing can ever affect it. And he doesn't need any upgrade. Or he doesn't need any assistance to make him function the way he functions.